Let's talk about installation of stainless steel and a tungsten point, even the pin nocks here. George, we got everything pretty much here on the table to install. We got our arrows, we got our points, we got our pin nocks, our alcohol, our glue.
Our safety glasses.
Oh, safety glasses, of course. Always make sure you're wearing safety glasses. But yeah, let's dive down into this. Let's have some fun. Let's build some arrows here and get some points glued in.
Correct point installation can make a pretty big difference in terms of the overall performance and longevity of your arrow shafts. You'll need a few tools and a few household chemicals to help to expedite your installation of your Easton points. First, we have isopropanol. This is lab pure isopropanol. It's not rubbing alcohol, Geoff. That's an important consideration because the commercial rubbing alcohol that you can buy at your pharmacy, that typically has oil in it that's meant to keep your skin from drying out. Rubbing alcohol, after all, is meant for like muscle massage. Isopropanol is what you can also buy from the pharmacy, and you usually can get it at 94% pure. The rest of it's going to be a little bit of water. This stuff is hygroscopic, so the longer you leave it out, the more water it'll absorb. So we keep it in closed containers in our labs here at Easton. And it'll help clean the dust from cutting your arrows. When you cut your arrows, Geoff, you're going to get some dust inside the tubes, so we like to clean it out. Now, what I have here is a commonly known here in the U.S. as a Q-tip, a cotton swab. Now you'll notice that the cotton swab is too big to go into the small diameter of the X10. So what we'll do is we'll pick some cotton off of the outside. And I like to do this just until I have just a little bit of cotton left on the outside of this thing.
Customize that cotton swab.
Yep, so we'll customize the cotton swab just enough to prevent it from jamming up inside the arrow tube. We'll just pull some off, a little bit of cotton, and then we'll take the remaining cotton and roll it down. Then we can take our isopropanol. Just a few drops is all it takes. And we'll use that to clean inside the arrow shaft. Now, if it gets stuck, all I have to do is just remove the little shoulder of cotton that builds up, and it'll go the rest of the way. And what I want to do is I want to get it in there about as far as that point is going to go.
You want to make sure to get in there, clean all that debris out of
there.
That's
right. Out comes whatever small amount of dust might have been left on there, and we're ready to go to the next step once this dries off.
Fantastic.
The other consideration is if we have cut this off with anything other than an Easton saw, we may find ourselves needing to deburr the tube very slightly.
Mm-hmm.
You can use an X-Acto knife, you can use a pen knife. You just want to remove the burr. You don't want to cut into the core tube. One of the better tools for this is Easton's dressing stone. Mm-hmm. That's actually meant for all carbon shafts, but it works really well for AC shafts as well.
Now, it's going to deburr the carbon. It's also going to deburr.
It only deburrs the inside of the ring.
And the inside of the ring.
Yeah, you don't actually want to touch the carbon. All you want to do is just put a very light deburr inside the tube.
And I see a lot of guys when they're doing this, they're like really cranking on it in their shop, and you don't want to do that.
What you don't want is to cut more than about 1/10 of the wall thickness. And since these only have a 5.5 wall, we're talking about removing about 50 millionths of an inch, so it's not much. Once the alcohol has dried from the inside of the arrow shaft, and you can expedite that simply by blowing some air across it, we're ready for the next step. The next step is to get our safety glasses on and get ready to work with glue and flame. First off, we're going to take our alcohol and make it go far away from where we're going to have fire. Now, this happens to be a like a map torch, but you can use propane or butane for this purpose.
Now, what kind of setting do you have on that?
We don't need SR71 afterburner. We just need a little bit of flame, honestly. And I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but what we have here is a very light flame, right? Yeah. The other things you can do this with are an alcohol lamp. You don't want to use a candle.
No.
You don't want to use naphtha. You don't want to use anything that's going to create soot.
Can you use a heat gun?
You can, but it's going to take a real long time. Whether I'm installing a steel point or a tungsten point, I'm going to follow the same basic procedure. That starts with holding the point in my fingers. The point, not the shank.
Right. Right? And you're not using pliers to do that. You're holding on.
I'm holding on to it because I want to feel it if it gets too hot.
Exactly.
So, first thing I'll do is I'll take my Easton hot melt glue. And by the way, Geoff, this is specially formulated for the purpose of arrow point installation. When Easton's engineers design our points, we also design in a glue gap that's intended to work with this specific hot melt glue formulated to our standards to provide for the ultimate in toughness, shear strength, low temperature performance, high temperature performance. This is the best balanced hot melt glue for the purpose of installing points into Easton arrows. Now it comes available in a couple of different packages, right?
Yeah, I was gonna say that. If any of our viewers are watching and you guys wanna know how to get this stuff, we have two different packages available online. Just go under the accessories and then adhesives, and you'll be able to find those at eastonarchery.com.
First thing I'll do is I'll take my Easton hot melt glue and I will warm it up in the flame just a bit, just to get it molten. And I'll take it while it's still molten and just tap it on the end of the arrow. And what that does, it'll create a little glue ring on the inside of the arrow that I'm going to push ahead of the point when I install the point. Doesn't matter if that actually ends up solidifying by the time I get to the point. The point will melt it.
Point will start to melt it, yep. Yeah.
Next thing I'll do, I'll warm up the glue a little more, and then I'll warm up the arrow point just a bit, just a couple of seconds through the MAP flame or the propane flame or the butane flame.
Yep, and again, still holding on to it.
Yep,
not using pliers.
Right, and I'll run it a little longer if I'm using an alcohol lamp because that's a lower temperature flame.
Okay.
Right, then I'll take my glue, and again, I'm heating up the glue, not the point. I'll put the glue all the way on the shank. Now, obviously, that's gonna create an excess of glue at the end, and we'll show you what to do about that. So here we have our Easton hot melt melted on the outside. Now I'm going to run it into the flame one more time.
Going to soften it up.
Soften it up, but I'm still holding on to the point. I'm being careful not to run my fingers into the flame. And now the end is warm and I can press the point in and you'll see it just goes right in. It's molten already. And I'm still able to comfortably touch this. Try that. It's less than room temperature.
Yeah, I can hold my fingers
on it. It hasn't transmitted the heat. I can push it in and I'll rotate the shaft as I push it in. Now, if it stalls out on you, just warm it up just a little more. Just a little. And press it home. Then, reasonably quickly, take a paper towel and wipe off some of the excess. You might end up leaving some on there. Don't worry about it. Alcohol will actually remove it. At this point, I'll take this arrow and I'll set it vertically, like in a cup, or some other means, and I'll let it cool to room temperature. Now, here's what I'm not going to do. I'm not going to take this thing and jam it into a container of water. And you may ask yourself, why not? And the answer is, I don't want to shock that glue into solidification. Mm-hmm. I want to allow it to properly cycle back down to its working temperature. And if I shock that, I might get a separation. And if I do, eventually you might get a loose point.
Don't get impatient.
Yeah.
Put it in cold water.
Because it's just a matter of minutes, right, until this is cool enough to touch. I can obviously touch this with no problem whatsoever.
Yes. So no problem.
The point itself is not too hot. The shank of the arrow is not too hot. We're good to go. To clean off the excess glue, all we have to do is take some more isopropanol on a paper towel and just wipe off the glue. Three or four passes with a paper towel.
And clean, no residue.
And it's completely clean. No residue left whatsoever. One thing that you don't want to do is leave a great big bead of glue on there, because the glue is quite tenacious. And if you're not careful, if you go and rip the ring of glue off, you can actually pull some carbon fiber off. That's not a good day. So we do want to make sure that you do clean off some of that while it's still, you know, somewhat molten on the arrow shaft. If you find yourself having forgotten to do that, just make sure you pull toward the point, and that way you won't possibly pull some carbon fiber.
It's easy as that. Like, you can, you know, anybody can do this with proper equipment.
For sure, if I can do it, anybody can.
Anybody can do it if you can do it, George. You've only been in the industry for how long?
Too long. All right. Next step, though, is to talk about the tungsten point installation. Now, with the tungsten point, basically it's the same process, but there's one consideration that you need to keep in mind when you're working with a tungsten point and a flame. Because it's so dense, the heat will travel a lot faster through the tungsten point, and it'll get hotter faster. So we need to work a little more effectively, a little more efficiently, okay, with the tungsten point. Again, the steps I'll take are to take our MAP flame, and again, butane or any other non-sooting flame is the way to go with this. I will warm up some of the glue.
And you've already cleaned that arrow shaft out.
Yeah,
we're good to go on that one.
I'm going to put a little ring of glue, just like I did with the steel point, and I'm going to let that sit there. Now I'm going to take my tungsten point and I'm going to put just the tip of the point into the flame, not the entire shank, just the tip of the point. and I'm going to put a little glue on there and a little more on the shank. Now it's already getting warm. I can tell, I can feel it.
You can feel it.
But if I work quick enough, I've got just enough time to do this. It's still not too hot to hold. I've got time to put it in the arrow shaft, especially if you're a recurve shooter because you got no nerves left anyway. I'm joking. Now I'm going to take this and warm it up this way, just for 3 seconds or so, and press it home. Then I take my paper towel. I still have that ring of glue on there. Done. I'm going to let it sit until it cools down. Now it's going to take a little longer to cool down with the tungsten point than with the steel point because of the density, but not so much longer that it's going to be a big deal. Again, don't throw it in water. Let it cool down naturally.
Now, George, we've talked about installing the points. Now, what if we got another dozen arrows and we want to reuse our tungsten points or reuse our steel points?
Yeah.
How do we go about getting those points out?
Basically, two methods. Earlier, you brought up using a heat gun. That is where you are well served. A heat gun can work very well for warming this up enough to be able to remove the point. See, the reason I don't recommend a heat gun for installation is it takes too long to warm things up, and then by the time it's warm enough, everything gets too warm. Right. That's why I like to use a flame. But I like to use a heat gun for removal of points. The other thing that can work is boiling water, if you're at an altitude that allows for the water to be at a full 100 C.
Okay.
So boiling water is going to be enough to loosen this bond and allow you to remove the point with pliers. The third method is for, I would say, the brave of heart. And it's the method that I always use. And what I'll do is, because Easton uses the highest temperature resin system in the industry, you can actually get away with passing the arrow into the flame very briefly, like so.
Not holding it there long, but three times.
Just three or four times, okay. Right? And now, using a pair of pliers, and I might want to tape the pliers to keep from marring the point, but with tungsten it's so hard that it's sure. Well, you kind of almost got to go out of your way to screw this up.
Yeah,
but you'll notice it starts to loosen.
You get a little bit of movement there.
I'm going to warm it up just I'm going to touch it, see if I've got it too hot. It's not. I'm going to warm it up just a little more. I'm going to warm up the point itself, because remember that tungsten transmits the heat at a tremendous rate.
Transfer down.
I'm going to let it sit for a second, and now starting to come out. So I'll hit it one more time. I've got it loose from the point. This time I'm just putting the heat on the point itself, not the carbon. So I sort of pre-warmed the carbon,
yep.
But now the point's going to get the lion's share of the temperature. I'm going to let it soak through and yeah. Out it comes.
There you go, perfect. Yeah, and you can start to feel that. You can feel the pressure on. I can see it too.
And so now I've got a reusable point ready to go. I might want to leave it on a surface for a little while, but you'll notice I didn't get it so hot that I can't pick it up. I wouldn't touch the point end, but the shank end, which has got the heat soaked through.
Yeah.
And you'll notice it's got sticky glue on the outside of that.
Yep.
You may want to clean that off if it is dirty, or you can just add more fresh glue and put it right into your new arrows.
You were wondering where to get these pliers from. These are on EastonArchery.com. Again, just go to accessories and then other tools. You can find access to these pliers. Cool thing about the pliers too is, if you are pressing in points or something and you need to, you can press that point in. You got two different hole slots here for that.
Yep. Also, you've got these two slots here that'll work for D-loops.
D-loops.
These are awfully handy to have. I've got them in my toolkit because there's so many uses for these. If you bend a rest wire, if you need to make an adjustment on something. I mean, there even has a decent cutter.
Yep.
That allows you to cut wire.
Yep, for so, sure. It's a good all-around tool to have in the shop.
And hard chrome plated and a really high quality part.
George, today has been a fun episode on tips on points.
We got to use fire and everything.
Got to use fire. We had our safety goggles on. We got our Easton mat out here. We had all the supplies out here, though. To show you guys how easy it is to install points. Ask us questions on what you want to know about insert installation, about point installation. We'd love to hear it. Again, send us a like on our video so we get the feedback. We know you're liking the content here. Subscribe to our videos, and always visit EastonArchery.com for all your accessory and arrow needs.